Hey guys, just wanted to do a quick video. A lot of people have requested that I talk about these because a lot of YouTubers have kind of glanced and glossed over these. These by far are the most comfortable feeling Beats that there are. Now, Beats did release the studio buds today. Not interested in buds because I've had them, and I'm sure anyone else who's had them knows they get lost extremely easy. So my main thing is making sure that I'm able to keep my devices as long as possible. So, you know, these came out, I want to say, the end of 2019, went into 2020, and I got them, of course, this year. I was a little late on the train. It didn't come with much. When you take them out of the box, it did come with the coil charger, which was the lightning. It came with, you know, these, and they were inside the box. It came with 3 months of free Apple Music. And I would say, I think that was it. So you kind of put it back in the box, and that's kind of how the box goes. You sit it back in there, blah, blah, blah. Alrighty. So when you open them up, they automatically pair. So whatever your name is you have set on them, they're going to set when you first get them. They're going to ask you, what do you want to name them? Now they do sit in there kind of awkwardly. MKBHD pointed that out. So the first thing you're going to do, you're going to have problems putting them back in there, you know, because it doesn't come to you. You see, they use the magnetic pins. The magnetic pins are inside of there. You see, you get a lot of oily residue on here, and that happens. I mean, it's going to continue to happen too. Now, this button, which I did not know for a long time, is the reset button. So when you get a new iPhone, you kind of want to reset it. Even if it automatically syncs, you want to reset it. And the reason being, these things have some sort of problem where if you don't, your volume is extremely, I won't say deafening low, but damn near deaf. So you won't hear anything. Like, it's very very muted sounding. It almost sounds like you need to clean your ears out. So I had different tips on here. I lost one of them yesterday during an excursion, and this is the tip that I prefer to use. Drop that guy. Where is he at? Right there. So he is the tip I like to use the most. He has the, of course, flowered in and then the rounded bud at the tip. They fit well and they actually lodge in the ear. You're able to hear around you. Keep in mind that these do not have noise cancellation, and you cannot hear what's going on around you. So if these are in your ear, they're in your ear, buddy. So what I find to do when you remove them, they know you've removed them because there's a sensor that is here. You can actually see the sensor. Where is it at? See, that is your volume buttons. The sensor's somewhere on here, and it's like super obvious. Oh yeah, there it is, right there. So you see the sensor right here. So what I do is I loosen it out of my ear. If this is my ear, I just loosen it like this. I just pull it out of my ear a little bit so I can hear around me. And then when I'm ready, I just push them back in. It does recognize it. And that's cotton that fell out because I have a habit of cleaning them with, I use an oil because I like them to be shiny. So he's an oil-based cleaner after I disinfect them. But, of course, all of the parts don't take because they're not all made of the same type of plastic. And same thing, you see the sensor is there. Now, on an average day, I can get about, I'd say about a full 2 days worth of listening out of these without charging. Conversation wise, now if I'm having a long phone conversation, as you can see, they're blinking. That's letting me know they're in there. The phone recognizes them and they're charging. So they're full, so there's no need for them to be doing that. So I'm gonna do that. The phone's gonna recognize it for a while. What that's also doing is notifying Find Me. So if anything happens and I happen to hit Find Me on my device, I'll be able to find and locate these. It's not that loud. The sound comes out of the earpieces, so it's not that loud. But if it's extremely quiet in the house, you will be able to find them. I've had to a couple times. They do not wirelessly charge. I've tried that with MagSafe and Qi wireless charging and power mats and everything else. They do not. You can see they charge with, yeah, lightning. And so, but it is lightning to USB-C. Now, if you give them a good 15 minutes, you will get about 8 hours worth of listening. That is extremely true. The battery life on these are great. The sound is extremely good. And you can actually tell which songs are actually mixed and mastered very horribly when you listen to these, because it really gives you the actual sound of the song. And that is one of the things that are great about this. So what I suggest is product in 2021 going into 2022 for the holiday, I absolutely would. This thing is not that big. You see these YouTubers, they complain, and you know, a lot of the tech YouTubers, they complain about everything. It does use the W1 chip, so it does pair automatically. You don't have to go through all the extra hoopla trying to do it. If you use it with Android, there is an application for it that helps you regulate the sound and things like that. But on iOS, there is no sound application. So, once again, I would definitely suggest these as a gift for the holiday for someone you know that loses their earbuds a lot, that may just want to use one. That hook, trust me, they do not come loose at all. They do not come loose. They're very private. I throw these in my tech bag and I'm gone for the day. So this is something I definitely would suggest. This is your boy, Freshest Nights, aka Skrill Dilly, Fresh Joy TV. Make sure you hit subscribe. Hit that like button so I can get in that algorithm and I can get some money and make some hell of a lot of better videos, because this iPhone 13 is giving me this cinematic mode. I'm really loving it, and it's probably the best my videos will ever look. So I thank you guys, and you guys have a good one. I'll be back with, I think my next video is going to be on 8.4 for the Apple Watch. And because we're on 8.3 right now at the time of this video on November 1st, and then we're gonna have 15.2 beta 2 is gonna be next for the 13 and the 13 mini. So we're gonna see what's gonna happen with that, if it's any good, if it's gonna kill battery. We're gonna go over what's new, what's not working, and things like that. So it'll be kind of a longer video. And I hope to see you guys there. Peace.